Harry, nice to meet you. FA Cup run is over, unfortunately, but I guess the good thing with football, you can put the disappointment away because there's another match straight away.
Yeah, that's the thing about football and this league, and well, every league to be fair, but it's a chance to go again so quick and get a positive result. And obviously the other night was not the best result for us. We wanted to progress through the competition, but you know, I thought we played well, and yeah, like you say, it's another game to put right on Saturday.
Or focus now on the league and those all important promotion places as well, I guess.
Yeah, exactly. Like I said, obviously we wanted to progress in the competition, but it is what it is. And now, like you say, it's a chance for us to focus on the league and push up the table.
I was reading an article on the website. You spoke after the Sunderland game, how proud you were of the young players for getting a win in such a tough place.
Yeah, you know, I think we're such a young group. You know, it's for a lot of us, we're still so early on in our careers. So to go to a place like Sunderland, which is, as everyone knows, such a good crowd and such a tough place to go to get a win, although they were down to 10 men, is such a good result.
Loftus Road, I imagine there could be a pretty lively bunch up there. What are your experiences of going up there?
I've never been. So it's the first time for me. So yeah, we'll approach it like any other game and we're looking forward to it. And yeah, hopefully we can get 3 points.
Not much that separates you and QPR on the table, just the single points. So I'm sure you're expecting a very tight encounter.
Yeah, it was similar to Sunderland. We knew last week that we could match them on points. So yeah, like you say, they're only a point behind us. So it's another chance to pull away from them and, you know, get a positive result.
You've had some good results in the league recently, decent away form. And what's the overall feeling that the performances have been pretty positive in general, I guess?
Yeah, I think, you know, obviously we've gone to this new formation recently, which I feel has worked really well. But yeah, I think performances have been the majority this season quite good. And sometimes the result hasn't quite gone our way. But, you know, I feel like we can start to turn that round now and turn good performances into good results.
Swans have been guilty of giving away a few soft goals here or there. How important is it that you tighten up and the concentration is 100% throughout?
Yeah, you know, we do a lot in training and we know ourselves as a defensive unit that some of the goals have been sloppy and not good enough for our standards. So, you know, we look at that all the time in analysis after games. And yeah, like I say, hopefully we can start cutting that out.
QPR, looking at their recent form, bit of a poor run at the moment, but got new management in, and teams with new management usually respond well. So you've got a sort of wounded animal to face tomorrow.
Yeah, but I think any team in this league is a tough game. So yeah, like I said earlier, we'll approach it like any other game and yeah, hopefully get a positive result.
Great, wish you luck. Thank you.
Morning, Harry, good to see you. You just touched on it there with the change of shape recently. You've played in a back three for a long spell here and under the manager at your previous club as well, but do you think this current system suits you better and maybe some of the other players as well?
I think, you know, you've seen from performances it's suiting us. I feel like we're playing well, but like the gaffer says, and you know, in the games it don't really look too much different in the games no matter what formation we play. So yeah, it's going well so far, and like I said, hopefully you can carry on.
You spoke about this a little bit when you first arrived at the club, that the manager knows you so well. He was so keen to get you here last year, eventually got you. And you know, how have you found it being here in terms of having worked with him previously and the step up to the Championship from League One? It's a big jump, isn't it?
Yeah, it is a big jump. But like I say, I know how the gaffer works, which is a big reason why I come. And he hasn't changed since my old club. So yeah, I knew what I was coming into with him. And yeah, he can only make me a better player. So it's all credit to Russ, really.
We've seen you chip in with some goals and stuff as well. I think Kerry touched on some of the sloppy goals, set plays, but attacking wise, you've proven that you're one of the ones that have benefited from that work. Just describe what Andy Parslow has done for you as a team in terms of trying to get the benefits out of those attacking set plays and defensive as well, I suppose.
Yeah, AP's been brilliant, to be fair. I think, you know, sometimes we've probably let him down on a few occasions defensively. But I feel like we do look fairly solid from defensive and attacking corners. But like I said, he's been brilliant. He does a lot of meetings with us and goes for a lot of detail. So, yeah, he does really well.
Just on the dynamic of the team, it's changed slightly with that change of shape you mentioned. It's been a big part of having Joe Allen back. He's come back from the World Cup. He's fully fit again now. How big an influence has he been? Obviously, it's a really experienced midfield in what is a really young team, isn't it?
Yeah, like you say, he's been there, done it. He's such an experienced player. He's played at the top. And like you say, with the old players, Grimesy and Jay, they've it's quite a good midfield, if I say so myself. So they've got a lot of experience, which can only help us young boys.
And we just heard from the manager that Morgan Whittaker is going to be in the squad tomorrow. Obviously, he had to miss the Bristol City games because he was cup tied, and Sunderland obviously with the situation with the Rangers looking at him as well. But what's he been like in training? Because he's been back for, I think, 2 weeks now. He's going to be involved with you.
Yeah, Morgan's been brilliant. Ever since he's come back, he's been really sharp in training. Obviously frustrating for him that he couldn't be involved in the squads, but testament to him, he's been brilliant. His attitude's been right, and he's trained really well. So.
And he's someone who's benefited from the loan system. Ollie Cooper, another one last year going to Newport. I mean, it's proof that it works. But for Morgan now, do you think he's really got to prove his worth at Championship level and show what he's capable of doing at this level?
Yeah, exactly. You know, he's done really well when he was on loan at Plymouth. You know, he scored loads of goals and got assists. So like I say, it's just putting that here now, and hopefully he can get a few for us.
Top man. Thanks, Harry.
Cheers.